Welcome back to another Google AdMob tutorial. Today, we'll be covering the first part of a two-part series about rewarded interstitials. In this first video, we will be introducing you to the rewarded interstitial ad format. We will illustrate how this ad format can drive more ads revenue for different types of apps. Next, we will highlight the difference between rewarded interstitials and rewarded or interstitial ads. Lastly, we will showcase some sample placements and rewards for rewarded interstitials to help you get started easily. Rewarded interstitial is a premium ad format where users can easily discover rewarded video ads. Instead of users needing to start the ads themselves, rewarded interstitials start automatically, making it even easier for users to discover the ads and earn rewards. With rewarded interstitials, the ads must be made skippable. However, there are ways in which you can encourage users to watch the full ad. For example, if users click to exit, a pop-up could appear to warn them of a loss of reward. Once a user watches the full ad, AdMob sends a video complete callback to grant the reward to the user. You can observe here the typical experience of users interacting with rewarded interstitial ads. They will first see the intro screen designed by the developer. Next, they will be shown a reward with a clear countdown timer and a skippable button. If the user chooses to click and exit the ad, they will be warned of a loss of reward. How does rewarded interstitials fit into your app? 1. The rewarded interstitial ad format helps you unlock new placements. You can do so with just-in-time and contextually relevant rewards. Because these ads pop up at key moments for users, instead of randomly, there is a greater likelihood that they will choose to watch the ad in exchange for a reward. 2. The rewarded interstitial ad format helps to replace rewarded placements with low engagement. With rewarded interstitials, you can track a boost in impressions volume, potentially leading to a revenue uplift. 3. With its just-in-time rewards, the rewarded interstitial ad format offers a superior user experience with minimal impact on retention. Placing such an ad at key moments gives users the boost they need to continue with gameplay, creating a positive user experience with the ads. What makes rewarded interstitials different from the typical rewarded or interstitial ads? Unlike rewarded ads, which a user must click on to start, rewarded interstitial ads are automatically surfaced while still giving users the option to skip if they do not wish to watch for a reward. You can adopt a diversified strategy by showing traditional rewarded ads to users who frequently opt in and showing rewarded interstitials to those who don't. If you are unsure on how to segment your users, we have a Firebase recipe here for you. There are two options to consider. Option 1. Use GMA SDK callback for on rewarded ad opened. This callback will signal when a user has opened a rewarded ad and hence will be classified as part of the rewarded opt-in group. Users who have not triggered this callback will remain in the no opt-in group. Option 2. Create a custom event based on when users click the rewarded prompt. You can segment your users based on who has and has not triggered the event. This approach is more customizable by the publisher. Both of these options allow you to show traditional rewarded ads to users who are likely to engage with them and show rewarded interstitials to users who may not be engaging with opt-in rewarded ads. For more information on how you can go about segmenting and testing this group, check out our Firebase video series in the description box below. Rewarded interstitials can help improve the experience of traditional interstitial placements as well. Say you're offering interstitial ads in between levels. For a better user experience, consider replacing the interstitial between levels with a rewarded interstitial. Rewarded interstitials with well-designed rewards are more enjoyable for users and can improve both eCPMs and retention, thus increasing user lifetime value. Now that we have discussed how rewarded interstitials can help improve both rewarded and interstitial placements, let's take a look at some specific examples of how to implement this new format. If you're a gaming app developer, consider positioning rewarded interstitial ads as just-in-time rewards. Just-in-time rewards can be placed at the start or end of a level to offer a boost or an extra try. You could also use them at strategic breaks in gameplay as long as they are well-designed and do not disrupt the player experience. Let's take a look at some examples. At the start of the level, you can choose to offer a rewarded interstitial ad in exchange for bonus items. This placement gives players an opportunity to start the level with an extra boost. Another option is during gameplay, when the user only has one move left, grant extra moves in the form of a rewarded interstitial ad. A third option is, at the end of the level, you can offer rewarded interstitial ads in exchange for double coins or points on top of what they've earned throughout the gameplay. Additionally, if you are an idle game developer, you can choose to show rewarded interstitial ads right after a user starts a new countdown timer. Rewarded interstitials aren't just for gaming apps. All developers can consider showing rewarded interstitials in the in-app purchase section to offer discounted items or a free trial. That's all we have for you in the first part of our rewarded interstitial video series. Before you jump off, we have more resources to share down by the description box to make your AdMob journey with us a smoother one. You can find resources such as the developer's guide for both Android and iOS in the video description box below. And one last thing, be sure to subscribe to the Google AdMob channel for more best practices and tips on how you can grow your app further.